Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of MPFL World. And yes, we are still on a break because of the coronavirus and we urge you to continue observing social distancing. But we here at MPFL World, we decided to keep you company by bringing you up to speed with what is happening in the MPFL, even though we are on a break. Today on the show, we take a look at how the coronavirus pandemic has affected the MPFL and what are the financial implications, and we try to take a look at what to expect from the league when the coronavirus pandemic finally comes to an end. We will be talking to football writer and MPFL expert George Apayan in that regards. Also on the show today, we will be having updates on the inquiry into the death of Nasarawa United defender Chinenye Martins. We will be speaking to China Chero, a member of the special committee set up by the NFF, as he sheds more light on what the committee was asked to do. And finally,
Fanyo was a true ranger, committed to duty, and he possessed that never say die mentality.
In a way, he's on the pitch, you kind of have that hope, maybe something would still happen. You want to have a fine job.
We pay tribute to Enugu Rangers striker, Ifeanyi George, who a few weeks ago passed on tragically in a car crash alongside two other footballers. We will be talking to two people who were very close to the player as they tell us more about him. It's a brand new edition of MPFL World and it starts right now.
This is MPFL World with Diego.
Let's start with some updates from the league. And tragedy was averted on Friday morning after Abia Warriors goalkeeper Charles Tambe was attacked by hoodlums while he was having his morning workout at Ibadan. Tambe, who is currently at Ibadan with his family as the MPFL is on a break because of the coronavirus, was attacked at the Apata area by hoodlums who collected his wristwatch and phone before shooting him in the hand. Fortunately for him, Charles Tambe did not sustain any major injury and is expected to make a full recovery very soon, according to a club statement. MPFL clubs Enugu Rangers and Kano Pillars have pushed back their resumption dates by 2 weeks due to the current lockdown imposed by most state governments as the nation combats the coronavirus. Players from both sides were supposed to return to training on Monday. Both teams have now asked players not to return to camp but continue to observe the lockdown, which is ongoing. It should be recalled that the MPFL was suspended indefinitely following match day 25. Today on MPFL World, we are looking at the impact of the coronavirus on the league, both financially and also on the field of play. During the week, we spoke to football writer and MPFL expert George Apayan, who started by pointing out some of the financial implications of the break on the league.
Consequence plain to you financially, because as we did so, I did sure says, for instance, LMC will get partnership with some people, some companies. Definitely, those companies who would watch, because those companies as well, they're not in business currently. Nobody, everybody sit down for house. So, as it is, even the people where LMC them sign TV deal with to produce, you know, games for them. Those people be want test run some things recently with games we will come up, but right now they're not going to be one, because the most important thing for us now to stay safe right now. That one alone, they're not going to produce those games in the manner of test running it and see whether they will be make some small shader from the thing. Then at the same time, LMC too. They expect some kind of money from these people. Everything don't stop as it is now. So where will they head now? We don't know, because it's in till further notice. On the club side, you know, in our state government, they fund most of our clubs. That's in a big wahala, because now state government too, will they look up to the center to help them with money to fight the current crisis with it now, which is COVID-19 ahead. So that's not a problem. Nobody will even think of football first. Because right now, all the money now to channel and say, make we fight to keep ourselves alive. So Now, big problem it will be.
One other big question on the lips of every follower of the NPFL is what approach to take towards concluding the 2020 season. Already in recent days, Abdul Maikaba, who is the coach of NPFL club Plateau United, who currently sit top of the table before the break, has called on the season to be ended and the title awarded to his team. This declaration, of course, obviously met so much rejection by so many stakeholders, including the head coaches of Enugu Rangers, Rivers United, and so many other NPFL clubs. George Appian also voiced his fears and concern over the conclusion of the current NPFL season.
The moment where they say we make the go house to further notice, I don't know, say, they let down day. Because I look the calendar, I look matches will remain. We, you know, say, aim for them, then get outstanding.
They get 5 outstanding waiting.
So then we never even talk Federation Cup, how we will shook all those ones, put in between, so that we will fit, even meet up with the calendar. And then walk till the players begin to them. Sunday, Wednesday. But how we want to take one? Because the financial aspect of that one too is the ground.
Mm-hmm.
So we will need to put the two together, the financial aspect, trying to meet up the calendar and a whole lot of things. Because you know, we just do it. So the clubs, the organizers, in fact, it will take time. Then make you also look at this, the second tire, which now would be NML, never even kick one ball. It just be like one person say middle of ocean. Then you don't know whether to run, go left or right, because the water just is scatter from every corner. So now so the situation be right now. And I know MV whoever they in charge of. I know MV LMC, I know MV the clubs.
Still in the NPFL, with most clubs not able to train because of the ban on football and also the ongoing lockdown put in place by most state governments, we begin to wonder how most clubs are checkmating their players and their training regimes. We spoke to Lobi Stars head coach Benga Ogunbote. We started by asking him how he has been keeping tabs with his players.
Of course, yes. What I did was to do it in batches. Every day I make sure I speak with one or two batches, so making sure that they follow the training program that I've given them. Before we are back on the program, on this unwanted break, I had already discussed with them what I wanted from them, but I didn't know it was going to be this serious. Ever since it became a serious issue, and there are policies coming out from the government that we have to adhere to. So I speak with them, I monitor those of them with injury, and those that are fit to train, we give them program. And like I told you, I can tell you by 5 o'clock, my players should be on training.
Question which I can't avoid but ask you is, if at all the COVID-19 break extends more than required, do you suggest we scrap up the league, or what are you suggesting should be the outcome?
Well, I think it's a difficult one for me to answer, because this case is a global affair, and it's just difficult for just an individual to just wake up and say this is what will happen or this is what should be done. So we just hope and pray that the break is not unnecessarily too prolonged, so we can go back to our games back. But if otherwise, whatever the decision that is taken or gym fit to be taken that is taken, there's nothing anybody will do.
Thank you very much, coach, and we appreciate you for your time.
NPFL World is open for sponsorship and partnership. You can email us at diegosports@gmail.com or call Stephen on +234 901 716255.
You're still listening to NPFL World, and remember, our podcast is available on Anchor FM, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and of course on Diego Sports YouTube channel. We would also love to hear from you and what you think about the show. Simply drop a note on the comment section of the platform you're listening from, or send an email to diegosports@gmail.com. And if you enjoy the podcast, don't forget to click the like button and share the links to your friends and contacts. Following the tragic death of Nasarawa United defender Chinenye Martins in March, the Nigerian Football Federation, in partnership with the league management company and the Ministry of Sports, announced several steps which they will take in order to improve the safety of players during football matches. One of them was setting up a special task force to conduct an inquiry over the death of the player. Results of the inquiry were supposed to be submitted to the Sports Ministry and the NFF a few days ago, but the meeting was postponed because most of the members of the committee could not attend the meeting due to the coronavirus lockdown. NPFL World caught up with China Chero, who is one of the members of the committee, to find out how far the committee had gone into its findings. We started by asking China what was the mandate given to them by the NFF.
We start work for Benin when they inaugurate us, like you know. Now 3 points they give us. One, to map out security and safety regulations for the league. Then also to determine who can kill that boy and how could we stop that from happening. So for security and safety regulations, now we all of us are there already. So we do that for Benin. We open car guidelines, we open car guidelines, we use our brain. We put them together, we all write what we feel is supposed to be the standing security and safety regulations for Nigerian football, not just league. Even if a Super Eagles they play or Super Falcons they play for Nigerian football, hello, we do that one there. We now take break. We resume on Sunday last week for Abuja. From there, we enter Lafia, where the main cocoa happened. We reach Lafia on Monday. We come meet with the FA chairman, FA secretary. The chairman of the club, Dala D.I.D., the secretary of the club, the doctor who signed the medical report whether that boy used play ball this season. We meet with him. We meet with the medical crew of the team. We meet with the captain of the team, Imam Makama, and one of their players. So, from the questions we ask them, and we think they answer us. Then we will use, write our report, people will send us. But when they go back to Abuja, now we hear say the country is on the cruise, make everybody go in one house. So we suspend. But after they talk to you now, we know our finding. We know our resolution. Now just enter, we minister, call us, we put up a book, give and say, Oga, take. Now they walk here and give us this. So make us just know, say, we don't ready. Now just say this COVID-19 will stop everything. Mm-hmm. And I need to go hard, but we don't ready. We know we think the cost problem for Nigeria football. I will know if the beast follow within we write. So that everyone is fear. If the people follow within we write.
Yeah, because now we question with everybody's mouth now. Whether these findings, this submission we wanna go through, whether they go follow and whether they go implement them, even if not be 100%, but even half of it. Because we know it not be the first time we get similar sort of inquiry, but what we don't do in the past to follow up the recommendations, we know today positive. So the question I say, they go follow them.
You just say, Diego, I never entered any committee before, so I don't know why they are not following within the other committee stock.
Yes.
But you can say, to make the way they send us, once we do and complete, carry the paper, chief minister, our work don't finish. Whether they pull them or not, they know their hand again.
Yes.
Now, on our hand, we be, because they ask them every morning, every afternoon, every night, they are, on that thing, week, on that minister, they see what this will give on, and I never do them. That one now, but we are always say, we need to submit our first. And we tell ourselves, say, we no more follow our hands for this matter. We won't write them as it be. So if we can carry our file, put on that table or put on that drawer, if we can open that file, come on, the just with the body, if they read them, they will not say, the poor way do that work, they don't follow hands.
Exactly.
So we don't try our best, and we will do our best. So, while they follow the result, which you write or not, that one, like the back away, Nigeria Football Federation has 40 minutes to go answer. And media people, they will ask them questions, but for we, once they call us and we submit that thing, our hands don't come up on the work. I will believe we don't do our best and we will not fall hand.
Our final question before I leave you. Do you say in future, say we will avoid this kind of situation where we go wait until something bad happens before we will start to ask ourselves a question? Say, wait till we do wrong, wait cause this thing to happen.
The truth is, say, all over the world, people they take things or certain things for granted until they get happen.
Mm-hmm.
See, this matter with COVID, the warriors, Yeah, since December, we have the COVID-19 in China. Since December. So not just Nigeria, even America, even UK, even the United States, even France. Everybody should not forget the watch. But you enter. They have done the same measure. So, that's how worthy it will be. Not be Nigerian matter, not be African matter. That's how worthy it will be. Even for England. It took you the only for well. Let's say the first Champions League final, Liverpool and Juventus. First stage, we about 39 people died. 1989, FA Cup semi final for England. We were for Hillsborough. We 96 Liverpool fans died. It took all this. So England considered themselves, look, we know we can continue like this. But we did go to every stadium must get seat complete. Nobody could stand on the stadium again. Every seat, they will write number on top. Everybody will buy tickets to see that for your number. They will collect your name, your address, your phone number. So in case they get home for your seat, they will arrest you. Now, most people, they will clean up their game.
Yeah.
But the point is, yes, it all happened. Now, I don't believe this is where we die. I think nobody die for nothing.
Yeah.
So I think that Nigeria will wake up. But I will tell you, Diego.
Yeah.
I will tell you, Diego. The thing we are seeing, the thing we are seeing for Lafayette, the thing we are seeing. If they don't implement waiting, we write, many people will still die for Nigeria football. And you can say, many people will still die for Nigeria football. We just start. So the point is, as Amadou Pini talk, when talk, even if it means they will push out from NFL because of this matter, he will make sure we implement everything. I don't think Amadou will do what I'm asking talk. But if he's not doing what he talk, bros,
you're listening to MPFL World with Diego.
Finally on the show, we pay tribute to Enugu Rangers forward Ifeanyi George, who tragically died in a car accident alongside two other footballers on the 22nd of March. Ifeanyi George, who was nicknamed Odogwu by the Rangers fans, became a cult hero after his outstanding performance in the 2018 Federation Cup Finals between Rangers and Kanu Pillars, which Rangers won after coming back from 3 goals down to take the trophy on penalties. It was the first time Rangers were winning the Federation Cup in over 40 years. Odogwu was also popular for being the player that will always hold the club flag during the club anthem in home matches. Two people who probably knew Ifeanyi George better than all of us are team manager Amobi Ezeako and Enugu-based sports journalist Jane Nweze. We caught up with the duo to tell us more about Ifeanyi George.
And this time there's no mistake from George. A huge goal. Enugu Rangers International.
Well, Ifeanyi was a true Ranger, dedicated to duty, and he possessed that never say die mentality, which is the first attribute of every true Ranger.
He was also very concerned about the people around him. You can't have a discussion with him without, you know, him talking about one player or another that's probably going through a difficult time. Oftentimes, he tries to, you know, do the most he can to help them in his own little way. On the football field, he'll be missed. He'll be greatly missed. You know, when he's on the pitch, you kind of have that hope that, no matter the amount of mistakes you might just get to make, that, you know, maybe something would still happen. You want to have a fine judge on the pitch. So it's one of the things that they would be missing about the loss of a fine judge.
3 days before he died, I took him to a scan center because he had an injury against Adamawa United. I took him for scan. And then while we were waiting for the doctor, I was telling him that this season will be his last in Rangers, that I want him to go to Europe so that he will continue playing his trade there and putting a smile on our faces. He said yes, that he's even thinking of the car he's going to buy for me when he gets to Europe. So these are memories you remember, and then you feel weak, really. But in all, I am consoled by the fact that he lived a good life. You know, as a footballer who is exposed, who sees a lot of things, he had self-control and he played with all sense of humility and responsibility. That's actually my sincerest consolation.
some heartwarming emotional words coming from Jane Wenze and Amobi Ezako. And from all of us here at MPFL World, we extend our deepest condolences to the family of Ifeanyi George and the whole Rangers International Football Club. We've come to the end of MPFL World, and remember, maintain social distancing and maintain proper hygiene as we continue the fight against coronavirus. Until I come your way next week, remember, now our league and only us, female can better.
MPFL World is brought to you by Diego Sports. You can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Diego Sports.